Hey guys, how's it going? Welcome back to FizzWiz. I'm Manish Sharma, and in this tutorial, I'll be showing you guys how to place an adsorbate on a surface using Vesta. So for the sake of this tutorial, we'll be trying to reproduce a result that looks kind of something like this. So we will try to place a water molecule, as you can see right over here, on top of the graphene surface, or rather the graphene monolayer, right? So the first thing that we need for this tutorial is, of course, the structures of the H2 water molecule as well as the graphene monolayer. So in order to get those, so first of all, to get the graphene monolayer structure, we'll Google C2DB database. So it's a really nice database for 2D materials. Just click on the first link that takes you to this URL, c2db.physique.dtu.dk. And then just search for carbon, essentially, because that is all that graphene is. And in order to simplify the search results, you can set the number of chemical species to 1, because we already know there's just carbon in there. And yeah, so here is the results. So as you can see here, that the band gap is 0. So I get like this gives you a pretty good idea that, of course, this is graphene. So yeah, so let me just go ahead and open it. And so here is the visualization of the structure, and of course it is a typical graphene monolayer. And just to confirm, you can also have a look at the electronic bands and switch to band structure, and you see the typical band structure of graphene. So yeah, so now what we are going to do is we are going to get the structure in the form of a SIF file. So it's saved on my downloads folder by the name 2c12.sif, and you can just go ahead and open it in Vesta. So this is how it looks. So in order to make this what I have here already, so I need to create a supercell, and here I have a 5x5 supercell monolayer. So first thing that I would like to do here is, you know, Vesta is usually really wonky that it puts all these extra atoms beyond the boundary or the cell. So first thing that I would like to do here is go to edit, go to bonds, and then select this and set it to do not search atoms behind or beyond the boundary, and click on OK. So yeah, this looks much better, because the SIF file only contains two atoms. So the unit cell only contains two atoms, and earlier it was showing so many more atoms, and still you are seeing more than two atoms. But that is understandable, because four of those are at the corners of the unit cell, so they are shared. All these atoms are shared between four unit cells. So yeah, so that's why, even though you see four of those, they are just equivalent. So in all, you have one atom at the corner, and then one atom in the unit cell. And actually, what you can go ahead and do further is, if you want to avoid seeing these atoms at the corners, you can also go ahead and click on object, then go to boundary, and then just set the X max and Y max and Z max to a really like high value, but just a very tiny, a bit smaller than one. So now if you do it, you will notice that now you're only seeing one at the corner, that is the origin, and the other in the unit cell, you're not seeing these periodic images, these spurious atoms. Yeah. So next, as I mentioned, we need to create a supercell. So now what we'll do is go to edit data, then unit cell, then go to transform. Then here is where you can specify the supercell dimensions. So like I want it to be a 5x5 in XY direction. So I'll do that, click on OK, then click on Yes, then select search atoms in the new unit cell and add them as new sites, click on OK, then OK again. And here you see a 5x5 supercell of the graphene monolayer without the spurious atoms at the boundaries or beyond the boundaries in Vesta. Now the only thing left is to add the water molecule, which is what this tutorial is about. So let's go ahead and go to this URL in order to download the water molecule as an XYZ. So this is a web app that I created for TurboMole. And once you are here, you will head over to pubchem2ripper. So here essentially it will search for the any molecule that you enter in the PubChem database and give you the XYZ as well as the TurboMol or Ripper co-ord file. But yeah, here we just need the XYZ. So we'll type in water and hit enter. And yeah, so it found one and you can download it in the XYZ format. So just go ahead and click download XYZ. And again, it is in my downloads directory by the name molecule 4. So now what I'll do is I'll open Vesta, and also I can like visualize it just for the sake of it, so you can see, okay, this is what I have downloaded. Now, coming back to this supercell that I've created of the graphene monolayer, what I'll do is I'll come again to edit, then I'll go to edit data, then I'll go to phase this time. So phase, and here you will import this molecule that you just downloaded. So it was by the name molecule 4, and hit open. So here it is. So now you have imported this molecule, and now if you just go ahead and click on apply, you will see that the molecule appears right at the origin of the unit cell. So it's quite a bit down there. And now what you can do is you can translate it along the A lattice vector, B lattice vector, and Z lattice vectors via these numbers or these fields. So first thing I'll do is I'll try to translate it towards the X or A lattice vector by, let's say, clicking, setting it to 3, hitting apply. So okay, now it is here. And now let's say I want to place this water molecule between, or like in this hollow region right here, in this benzene ring kind of structure. So let's say I want to place it here. So I think this X position I'm really happy with. Now I only need to raise it along the Y axis. So let's try 5 and hit apply. Okay, I'm pretty close. Maybe I'll decrease the X slightly to reach this center of this hollow. Okay, 2.7 should do the trick. And now I'll slightly raise it along the Y axis as well. Let's see, apply, okay, maybe slightly more. Yeah, okay. And maybe reduce it further along the X axis. So it's at a nice place that I would like it to be, but I also need to raise its Z coordinate. So now let's go ahead and do that and try a big number such as, let's say, 8. Hit apply. Okay, so it's now right in the hollow region. Maybe we need to raise it a bit more. Let's try 9. Yeah, okay, so this seems much better, but still pretty close to the surface. So I guess 9.7 or something should do the trick. Yeah, this is something that I'm really happy with. So yeah, so now what you can do is you can go ahead and click on OK. So this is our structure right here that we wanted to create. That is, we wanted to have the water molecule on top of the graphene monolayer. Now the only thing next left to do is to export this structure for our use in another DFT software such as WASP. So let's try to export it as a postcard. So now this is very important. Something that I'm going to mention now. So if you remember earlier, what I did was I prevented the periodic images of these atoms from showing at the boundaries as well as beyond the boundaries. And that is really important. That was not just for my aesthetic or like personal preference, but also for what I'm going to do now. So what I'm going to do now is I'm going to click on file, then I'm going to click on export data, and then I'm going to select this WASP postcard format and name it water on graphene 5x5 and hit save. And now you can set the atomic coordinates to be in Cartesian coordinates. And now this is the most important part. Now if you just select output current unit cell, in my experience it does not export the water molecules, or it just exports the graphene's coordinates. And that is why what you need to do is you need to set output coordinates of all displayed atoms. But when you do that, you need to really make sure that you don't have these spurious periodic images atoms at the boundaries as well as beyond the boundaries. So that is why the earlier two steps that we did are really important. Now what you can do is you can click on OK. And now let's go ahead and check our downloads directory for this file. So let me go ahead and refresh it. So here it is, yeah, water on graphene, fiber fine. Let's go ahead and import it in Vesta again. Okay, so it imports kind of funny. You see this infinite sheet, but again, it is very easy to solve. Go to edit, go to bonds, and select DC. Do not search beyond the boundary. Do not search beyond the boundary. Okay, so it's the same as what we did before. And the good thing is that you can see that the number of atoms in this system is 53. So you should always ensure that the total number of atoms in the structure that you made is correct or not. And how do I know that it is? It should be 53. So 3 are from the water molecules. So let's get rid of those. And the remaining 50 come from the graphene. So if you remember, the unit cell had 2 carbon atoms. And I created a 5x5 supercell. So 25 times 2 is 50. And that is why I have 50 atoms of graphene and 3 atoms of water molecule. So yeah, so that is, I think, pretty much it for this tutorial. I showed you how to download the graphene monolayer structure, download the XYZ of the molecule, and then I showed you how to get rid of the spurious atoms at the boundaries and beyond the boundaries, and I showed you how to place the water molecule on top of the graphene, and finally I showed you how to export it in the PostgreSQL format for use with WASP. So yeah, so I hope you guys enjoyed this tutorial and found it useful. In case you did, then don't forget to hit the like button and subscribe to my channel for more videos like this. Thanks for watching and have a great day.